excited?
Yes.
See, I'm not going to tell you the lesson name. I will just give the intro and you have to guess the name of the lesson. Let's see that you can guess the name of the lesson. Okay, just see. In particular seasons, we wear the particular cloth. For example, in winter, we prefer the woolen cloth. So can you tell me, why do we prefer the woolen cloth during the winter season? Yes, it keeps us warm. Am I right? Woolen cloth keeps us warm. Am I right? And why do we prefer the cotton cloth during the summer? See, during the summer, what is the condition? We feel very hot. Am I right? You feel very hot because of the sun's heat. Am I right? We feel very hot. So we prefer a cotton cloth. Am I right? We prefer the cotton cloth. In winter, we feel very cold inside our home. Am I right? But as you go out in the sun, we feel little bit warm. Am I right? So how do we know whether the particular object or particular season is hot or a cold? Can you just tell me how do we can feel it? So which is the object? How we can find whether the object is hot or the cold? Can you just tell me how we can find whether this object is hot or this object is cold? But before that, see, there are some objects. So this is ice cream. It is hot or cold? Yes, of course cold. Am I right? This is a spoon in the teacup. Whether it will be hot or the cold? Tea is hot or cold? Yes, of course it is hot. Am I right? So the spoon will be, obviously it will be hot. Juice. This is a juice. Whether it will be hot or cold? Yes, juice is cold. So tick to the cold. See, the chart is given in your textbook. You have to do the tick mark there. Okay? Then, handle of the frying pan. Yes, it is a hot. Yes or no?
Yes.
So it may be hot. See, it depends on the which type of the handle it is. If it is of steel, it may be hot. Or if it is made of plastic, it may be cold. Are you getting this? So there are some objects. They are hot or some are cold. Or some objects are more hotter. Or some objects are more colder. Am I right? So we should handle the hot object very carefully. For this, we are going to do an activity. It is given in your textbook. So now see, how we can recognize whether the object is hot or a cold. Can you just tell me whether the object is hot or the cold? How we can recognize? By our sense. But can our sense of the organ will be reliable for it? Just we will do one activity of this. See, the activity which is given in your textbook, try at home. But be careful while doing the activity, okay? You have to do activity with the help of your parents. Don't do by yourself, okay? See, first, there are the three bowls. You have to take, in a one bowl, you have to take a hot water. In a B bowl, you take an ice water, okay? Just deep your hand in that both A and B simultaneously. You have to dip the hand in A and B, where A is hot and B is cold. And in C, you take the warm water, lukewarm water. You have to take a warm water, okay? And you, after 2 or 3 minutes, you have dipped your hand in A and B, that is hot and cold water. You have to remove your hand and dip in the warm water, that is in the container of C. So can you just tell me what will be the scenes? Yes, when you will remove the hand from the hot water and when you will put in the if you have put the in hand, this hand, this side hand, if you have put in that sea, then you will find that right hand side hand, it may be, view of you might be feeling little bit cold, am I right? But as soon as you remove from the cold water and if you will put in that warm water, if your right hand if you are putting in the cold water and if you have put in the warm water, then you can find that water is hot. Then whether this sense is a reliable? No. The touch or the sense of organ by touching is not reliable. No, that is the lukewarm water. Am I right? So the temperature it might be, what will be the result? That if it is a lukewarm water, but our sense is telling that as soon as we are removing from the ice water our hand, and if we are dipping in that warm water, we feel that water is very hot. Am I right? So that touch or the sense of the touch is not a reliable. Is not a reliable. Am I right? So the degree of hotness and coldness is nothing but to measure this, we need a temperature. We need the temperature. Are you getting? So a reliable measure we can say, measure the hotness of an object is the temperature. Is nothing but a temperature. And to measure the temperature, we require an instrument. That to measure the temperature, we need the instrument. That instrument is called as a thermometer. That instrument is called as a thermometer. In the
So students, have you guessed the name of the lesson? Yes, it is nothing but the heat. Yes. Now for this, I would also like to give an example.
If it is during winter season, if you are sitting near that fire, then you feel little bit warm. Am I right? So it gives means the fire, it gives us heat. Am I right? So heat is nothing but, it is the form of energy. It is the form of energy. So see, for this also you can do one activity. See, when you rub your hands, okay, am I right? The heat is generated. You feel little bit warm. Am I right? So heat is a form of energy. And if you know, if it is the form of energy, energy is nothing but the capacity to do work. See, energy is nothing but the capacity to do work. Am I right? So, and energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. It is the law of conservation of energy. So what? Energy can neither be created or cannot be destroyed, but it can be converted into one form to the another. See, energy is a form of energy, which heat is a form of energy which can be converted into one form to the another form. Am I right? When you were rubbing the hand, the mechanical energy was converted into the heat energy. The mechanical energy is converted into the heat energy. So what will be the SI unit of the heat? Can you just tell me? What will be the unit of the heat? Yes, the unit, the heat is measured in the form of joule and calories. Heat is measured in the form of heat, joule or the calories. So the SI, the standard unit of the heat will be the joule. What will be the SI unit of the joule? It is nothing but, SI unit of the heat is nothing but the joule. Okay. So now we can measure the heat in the two ways, joule as well as calories. So 1 kilocalorie is nothing but 1000. 1 kilocalorie is nothing but 1000 calorie, while 1 kilojoule is nothing but 1000 joule. But now see, if we want to convert a calorie into a joule, so 1 calorie, to convert calorie into the joule, so 1 calorie is nothing but 4.184 joule. So what is the 1 calorie is nothing but 4.184 joule. Okay, when we want to convert the calories into the June. Okay, so this was nothing but about the heat. Now see, if we want to measure or if we want to calculate the degree of hotness and coldness, we need that is called, we say that degree of a hotness and the coldness, we call it as a temperature. We call it as a temperature. And to measure the temperature, we need an instrument. Am I right? To measure the temperature, we need the instrument. So that instrument is called as a thermometer. Thermometer. Are you getting? Have you seen the thermometer? See, when you are feeling, when you have some kind of fever, am I right? The mother remove one instrument. So that instrument to check the hotness, means to check whether how hot, what is the temperature of that particular child. Then she used that instrument. So that instrument is called as a thermometer. Now, if you have observed the thermometer carefully, there are the two readings, lower and upper end. Are you getting? If you will see that the scale properly, there are the two points, that is 0 and 100. Am I right? So, 0 is nothing but it is the melting point of ice. And the 100 degree is nothing but it is the boiling point of the water. Where the water starts to boil. Are you getting? So, the thermometer has a three scales. That is Celsius, Fahrenheit and Kelvin. There are the three types of the scale. Are you getting? But we use, the Indian people use the Celsius scale. Now, what will be the SI unit of temperature? Can you just tell me? The SI unit, the standard, the temperature is measured with a Celsius, Fahrenheit and Kelvin. So, the SI unit, the standard unit of temperature is nothing but a Kelvin. And it is denoted by the capital letter K. It is denoted by the capital letter K. Are you getting? SI unit of the temperature is nothing but a Kelvin. Are you getting? So, these are the three types of the scale of the thermometer. So, now see, there are Celsius scale, Fahrenheit and Kelvin scale. In India, we use the Celsius scale. Okay? So, this scale was given, the name Celsius was given, the Celsius was given by the, after the name of the scientist Swinburne, Address Celsius. The Celsius name was given by the, after the name of the scientist, Address Celsius. Are you getting? And the Fahrenheit scale was discovered by the scientist Daniel Gabriel Fahrenheit. This was discovered by the scientist Daniel Gabriel Fahrenheit. Are you getting this? So, what is the range? Now, if you will see the scale, now you have the scale, am I right? So, on the scale, there are some marking, am I right? So, like that, on the, if you might have observed the thermometer, there are the scales to measure the temperature, am I right? So, the scale of the Celsius starts from 0 degrees, that is lower point is 0 degrees Celsius and the upper point is at a 100 degree Celsius. Then the next Fahrenheit scale starts from at 32 degree Fahrenheit and 212 degree Fahrenheit. Likewise, the Kelvin scale starts from 273 Kelvin to the 373 Kelvin, and these are the lower point, or we can say that ice point. Are you getting? And these are the boiling point. This is same lower point and upper point, lower and upper. Now, there are some conversion. When you convert the Celsius into Fahrenheit, now when you convert the 0 degree Celsius to the Fahrenheit, you will get 0 degree Celsius nothing but 32 degree Fahrenheit. So there are some formulas to convert Celsius to Fahrenheit, Fahrenheit to Celsius and Kelvin to Celsius and Celsius to Kelvin. That we will see in the next video. Conversion of this we will see in the next video. So we have learned the three types. of the scale of the thermometer, that is Celsius, Fahrenheit and Kelvin. Now, if you will see the thermometer, there are mainly the two types of thermometers which are given in your textbook. There are the two types of thermometer, that is clinical thermometer and laboratory thermometer. If you will see the construction of the clinical and laboratory thermometer is the same. If you will observe the both the thermometer, they are the same. Now, for example, see. Now, this is the clinical thermometer. What is the use of the clinical thermometer? Clinical thermometer, it is nothing but it is made up of the glass. In that, there is one a capillary tube which is filled with the mercury, plus or alcohol, mercury and alcohol. Likewise, same construction is there with the laboratory thermometer and clinical thermometer. The construction is the same. Laboratory thermometer is used to measure in the chemicals, means we use in the laboratory to measure the heat of the particular chemicals or the boiling point of the particular chemicals. Are you getting this? While clinical thermometer is used to measure the temperature of the body. Are you getting? But if you will observe the clinical thermometer, there is little bit bend in the capillary tube. See, can you see? There is a bend in the capillary tube. That bend is called as a kick. Why there is a bend in the capillary tube? See, what is the use of that key? Key is means when you, as soon as you will remove, if you will take the laboratory thermometer and if you will measure the temperature of the human body, and as soon as you will remove the laboratory thermometer from your mouth, then what will happen? That the level of the mercury, it will, as it comes in a contact with the air, it will falls down. But the use of the kick in a clinical thermometer tells you that the it will maintain, as you will remove from your mouth, the temperature will be maintained. Are you getting? So this is the use of the clinical thermometer. Clinical thermometer is also called as a doctor's thermometer. Now, can you just tell me what will be the normal body temperature of a human body? Yes, it is the normal human body temperature is nothing but it is 37 degrees Celsius, and in Fahrenheit we calculate as a 98.6 degree Fahrenheit. What is the normal body temperature of the human body? 37 degrees Celsius. In Celsius, it is 37 degrees Celsius. While in Fahrenheit, it is 98.6 degree Fahrenheit. Are you getting this? So this is the normal human body temperature. Are you getting? Now, the clinical thermometer, if you will see, the range of the clinical thermometer is as here. There are the two scales on the clinical thermometer, Celsius as well as Fahrenheit. There are the two scales on the clinical thermometer, that is Celsius and Fahrenheit. Are you getting this? But the range of the laboratory thermometer starts from minus 10 degrees Celsius to the 100, minus 10 degrees Celsius to 110 degrees Celsius. This is the range of the laboratory thermometer. And the main difference in the clinical and the laboratory thermometer is that in clinical thermometer you can see the key, which is little bit bent in the glass tube to maintain the temperature. The key is used to maintain the temperature. Now, if you will see in the laboratory thermometer, if you will keep that, then you have to observe the temperature as soon, and you have to note down the reading. Are you getting? You can't remove that thermometer and you can check the reading, because we cannot get the exact reading, because the mercury level may fall down. Are you getting? So this is the main difference between the clinical and the laboratory thermometer. Now there are some precautions to use the clinical thermometer. So what are that precautions? See, when you are removing the thermometer, you have to wash with the antiseptic solution, and then you have to give to the another person to check the temperature. Are you getting? Then while as soon as you will remove the thermometer, you have to check the you have to check the reading of the thermometer. If it is the mercury level may get rise, so you have to give some small jerk means what? You have to give like this some jerk so that the level of the mercury will come down, and you can get the exact reading of the temperature. You can get the exact reading on the thermometer. You have, first thing is, while before giving to the any patient, you have to give some small jerk, may bring that level down to a particular temperature, and means below the 32 degrees 37 degree Fahrenheit and you degree Celsius. Then after giving the jerk, just see that you have to clean with the antiseptic solution, and then you have to hold to the particular patients. Are you getting? After removing from the mouth, again you have to wash with the antiseptic solution, and you have to keep in that instrument. Are you getting this? So you have to take the care of the clinical thermometers. Are you getting? So I hope that you have understood this video. Thank you.